Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends, in the last lecture we have studied Boyle's law, Charles law as well as Gay-Lussac's law, and now we are going to start about what is Avogadro law. And this all laws are basically interlinked with pressure, volume, temperature. But now this is something which is related to a new factor, so let us learn about it. So the first thing is, what does it means? Avogadro's law states that at constant pressure and temperature, in this case the two factors are being kept constant, that is the pressure and the temperature. These two factors are being kept constant, and the volume of a gas is directly proportional to the number of moles of the gas. What does it state? That the volume of the gas will be directly proportional to the number of moles of the gas present in the present in that situation. And in this case, that is the pressure and temperature, the both are being kept constant. Or we could say in this manner also, suppose that if the number of moles of the gases increases, then the volume of the that particular gas will also increase. So it has various statements, but we could understand in this way also, that if the number of moles of gas increases, then the volume of the gas will increase. Or if we would say that if the volume of the gas is been more, that means it has more number of particles, or it will increase with the number of moles of the gaseous particle present in that gas, overall gas volume. So let us talk that what does it mean. So as it says that the volume of the gas is directly proportional to the number of moles, and the number of moles is represented by N. So I clearly say that V is directly proportional to N. And in this case, the temperature and pressure, the both are being kept constant. So therefore T and P are constant, which I have written here. So this is the two values, two factors that are been kept constant in this case. So suppose this condition would be different for different gaseous state of the same gas, but of different volume or of different number of moles. So I could write this thing as, since volume is directly proportional to N, so I could write this as V is equals to K into N. And again, this kind of K, that is, this is proportionality constant. This kind of proportionality constant we have studied in Boyle's law, Charles law, as well as in Gay-Lussac law. So suppose what I could write this as V divided by N is equals to K, where K is equals to proportionality constant. So this is the thing that I have wrote. But the gases will have different condition also. For example, if a particular gas has a volume of V1, so if it has a volume of V1, then the number of moles of that particular gas would be N1. And the proportionality constant would be the same. So for suppose if another gas, that is the same gas but of different volume is being present, that is V2. So if different volume is present, then that would be depending on the number of moles of the gas that is being present in that case. So in this case, V2 can be written as V2 divided by N2 is equals to K. So this is the thing that we have mentioned here. And again, suppose if I take the equation as equation number 1, and this is equation number 2 if I represent, and if I equate both the things, then what I could get is V1 divided by N1 is equals to V2 divided by N2. So this is the case. So this is nothing but the Avogadro's law. And Avogadro's law basically depends on the number of moles and as well as the Avogadro's number, because as we know that for 1 mole of a gas it contains that is 6.022 into 10 raised to 23 particles of that or molecules of that gas. So similarly it depends for the volume also. So for example, for 1 volume, as we have did already in the chapter, that is some basic course of chemistry, we have learned that 1 mole of a gas occupies 22.4 dm cube of the volume, and each and in which it contains, that is 6.022 into 10 raised to 23 particles of that molecule. So similarly, this law that has been based on for the gases, this law also implies that if the volume increases, that means the number of moles of the particle will increase. Sorry, if the number of moles of particle will increase, then the volume will also increase. So that is the condition which was talking about based on Avogadro's law. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood this video, and you share this video with your friends, and yes, don't forget to subscribe Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.